Hi, some of you seem to be struggling with the virtual grounds, so I want to quickly cover two aspects of it. The virtual ground is there because we don't have a negative rail supply, but then the virtual ground introduces an offset voltage into the system, and then additionally to that, you also have an offset on the sensor output. So there's a DC offset on the sensor input, or output, there's a DC offset because of the virtual ground, and you have to, in some way, take that away. And the reason you want to take that away is because the op-amp output needs to have a full swing. In order to get the op-amp output to reach large swing or the full swing, you need to put it its middle point more or less at 2.5 volt. So you've got offsets on the inputs of the op-amp stage, and then on the output, you want an offset of 2.5 volts, more or less, with a big swing around it. So I want to quickly talk you through the maths of getting there.
If we have this setup and we have a -5 and a +5 supply, and we have a proper zero ground in between the two, then our output would basically just be V out is equal to R1 over R2, minus VAC. So that's the signal we're trying to amplify. So just keep in mind, this V out here is actually relative to this ground. So it's V out minus VGND, and the same here, it's VAC relative to that ground. So it's actually VAC minus VGND. And in this case, we chose our ground to be 0 volt because we can choose what is zero and what not. It's all relative. So these terms, they just cancel out. So keep that in mind. Right, the next thing to keep in mind is that we don't have the -5 volts. So what we will use is a virtual ground. So just bear with me 1 second. So we will use our ground here. And on this side, we will use what we will term a virtual ground. I will draw it like this just to distinguish it from the proper ground. And this here we will call VGND. And in your mind, if it helps you, you can pretend this is 2.5 volts and this is minus 2.5 volts relative to this if this were zero. But don't worry too much about that. All right, so if you were to rewrite the previous function that we had, the previous transfer function, but with the VGND included, V out minus VGND, which in this case is actually not zero, minus VGND is equal to minus R1 over R2 times VAC minus VGND. You can use just normal KCL if you wanted to check that. It's that voltage, this current that flows here and the current that flows here must add up to zero. And this point here is, in terms of voltage, equal to that point there. So that results in this formula. Now, the thing to look out for is that your V out will be equal to minus R1 over R2 plus 1 plus R1 over R2 times this whole thing times VGND. So your output signal here will have a large offset, or at least an offset that's dependent on this term here. Now that is not ideal. If you consider the output of this here, you typically want to use an amplifier to amplify a very small signal. So whatever the small thing is, you want to blow it up on this side. And if this here is not symmetrical within, or at least in the middle of the full range that you have with your two rails, then you can't get a nice full signal that's blown up and uses the full spectrum. If you have an offset and your signal lies right there, then you're limited by how far you can go around that middle point. So we want to adjust the signal so that it's nice in the middle, and this term here will prevent us from doing it. So what we do is we add an offset here. We add a DC component, R2. So you will remember this signal here, or at least the circuit here, looks very similar to what we call an inverting summing op amp circuit. So the only difference is that here there'll be another term added. So let's just redo this term real quick. So Vout minus VGND minus R1 over R2. And if you use the KCL law again, then the three currents now reading into this point must be equal to zero, and it's yet again equal to VGND. So it's VAC minus VGND plus VDC minus VGND. That must be equal to this on this side. Okay, so V out is just equal to, so when you design the circuit, you want to choose VDC, this one here, you want to choose it such that it cancels out as far as possible the effect of this VGND, this virtual ground. So you want to make this term here such that V out varies between ground and 5 volt. So you want the net effect of this term to be equal to 2.5 volts. So you can now go and design this such that you manage to get that right. In your case, it's going to be slightly different. I'm just going to ignore this part just for a moment and just consider what your sensor actually looks like. So in your case, your input signal, let's call it VSense, that goes into R2 and into R1, and you're going to have to use the virtual ground as I've just explained, R1 and V out. So in your case, this VSense is essentially made up of a part that you're interested in. So let's call it, I'm just going to call it VAC. It's not AC, but it's the part that ranges from 34 to 42. And then you've got a DC offset, the part that you really don't care about, which is the part that goes all the way up to 34 degrees C from 0 volts, right? That's the offset, if you want. That's the part you want to get rid of. So in this case, it's two series supplies. So this whole thing here is the same as a DC supply in series with an AC supply, where this is VDC and this is VAC, if you want to think of it like that. Actually, just to correct something here, the VDC part is actually up to 38 degrees and 38 degrees. Well, let me just correct that actually. It's a horrible mistake, sorry. 42, 34, and that middle point here is the part that you want to get rid of. So that's 38 degrees C. Okay, so the DC that you want to get rid of is up to 38 degrees C. So now if you use KCL to calculate this, you'll get a very similar result. V out minus VGND is equal to, here we go. So if you calculate this out, you get V out is equal to minus R1 over R2 VAC. That's the part that we really care about. This is the part that we want. And minus R1 over R2 VDC. This is the part that we really don't want. Plus VGND. And this is the one that we have control over. 1 plus R1 over R2, if I'm not mistaken. So in this case, it's slightly different, and we need to now carefully consider how we want to go about this, because what you have in effect is you start off with this, and you have this DC component and this ground, and this DC component is different for each one of you, and it will be towards the lower edge of the scale. So it's probably going to be less than this VG and D. So you're going to have to calculate how much of a new DC do you add on top of this thing to cancel out this formula. So you can combine the two, but in effect, you want to ensure that this V out, or this V out after you've added either here or added stuff here, that that V out ranges such that it's nicely seated between 0 volts and 5 volts, with this DC aspect, this AC aspect here amplified, and the DC aspect removed through using math like this. I really hope that helps you a bit to get on the way.